Between grief and nothing, I will take grief. And it is that collective sense of mourning that unites the racing community here at Talladega Super Speedway. It was here that one of racing's best, Davey Allison, drove his first Winston Cup race. He won his first major race here. On July 12th, piloting his own helicopter, he crashed at this racetrack in the infield. Davey would die the next day. He was 32. He was a husband and a father of two. He was the son of legendary driver Bobby, the brother of another racer, Clifford, who also lost his life on a racetrack just last year. Hello, everyone. I'm Ken Squire at Talladega, Alabama. And yes, there will be a race today. And yes, we will see the likes of Earnhardt, Elliott, and 40 others dueling for 500 miles. But first, this track, this racing family, will pause to remember Davey Allison, a racer from Alabama, a man who meant so much to so many. Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention trackside now, where the next words you hear will be those of the Reverend Hal Marchman.
We are happy that you're here this memorable day when the racing fans of Davey Allison, his family of NASCAR, all of the people in the garage area and the pit crews and his loved ones are here to pay tribute to Dave and recognize his accomplishments and his exceptional character. We remember and pray for his family. He said his family was his first priority, and he said that NASCAR was his family. We remember his mother, Judy, and his father, Bobby, who are not with us today. We remember his sisters, Carrie and Bonnie, who are with us today. We remember the Alabama gang that was so important to him. And we remember his mentor and his dear friend, Red Farmer. We're here today with those nearest and dearest to Davey's heart, and they are on the stand with me. Davey's wife, Liz, his daughter, Christy, and his son, Robbie. His two sisters are also here with us, Carrie and Bonnie. Liz wants to speak to you today. And Liz, we know this is a difficult time for you, but we sure are glad you're here. God bless you.
The last 2 weeks have been really difficult for Robbie, Krista, and myself, and the whole Allison family. There have been times that we felt that we couldn't go on. The love and the support that all of the fans have shown to all of us has been just overwhelming. There's no way that we can ever thank each and every one of you for that love. I know that now we can all hold on to the memories of Davey and to try to go on with our lives. Davey's looking down on us today with a big smile on his face. He would be so proud of the love that you have shown to him and to his family. These are all the things that will help Robbie and Krista know how very special their daddy was to so many people. And there's something that I'd like to share with all of you today that's brought some peace to me, and I hope that it will to you. Please don't sing sad songs for me. Forget your grief and fears. For I am in a perfect place, away from pain and tears. I'm far away from hunger and hurt and want and pride. I have a place in heaven with the Master at my side. My life on earth was very good, as earthly lives can go. But paradise is so much more than anyone can know. My heart is filled with happiness and sweet rejoicing too. To walk with God is perfect peace, a joy forever new. Thank you all very much. God bless you.
God bless you, Liz, and your family. And every history book on stock car racing will include Davy Allison, a top contender and a great sportsman. We loved you, Davy. You were our son, our brother, and our hero. And now I can almost hear Davy say, "That's enough. Get on with the race. And you race fans, have fun." And will you join me in prayer? Almighty God, we thank you today for Davy's life, for his charisma, for the inspiration he was to all of us. He would not fail today to have us ask you to bless all of those who are involved in this race today on his home track. Hear us, Lord, as we all pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen and shalom. Now let us hear the musical group Alabama express their feelings for Davy by singing "The Fan."
Or toured the concert halls, we survived our share of bar rooms, stared at many motel walls. The years in Carolina and all the one night stands, what kept the fires a-burning back then was you, the fans. We two stepped out to Texas, round and round the dance hall floor, played the fair in Minnesota. I wish we could have played one more. We hope you remember, we're just the boys in the band, and what keeps the fires a-burning is always you, the fans. I wish this night could last forever. But the show must go on. We'll take home the memories, and we'll leave with our songs. It's been good to see y'all. Can we come back again and again and again? What keeps the fires a-burning in us is you, the fans. long as you remember the boys in the band. We'll keep the fires a-burning for all of you, our
CBS Sports presents the Diehard 500, sponsored by Diehard, the official battery of NASCAR. Ford and your Ford dealer, have you driven a Ford lately? And by Goodyear, number one in tires.
And so now the show must go on, and some racing questions are to be answered, especially for Bill Elliott. This superstar has not led a lap all season. Today, he sits on the pole. Is the slump over? For Dale Earnhardt, the question is, will he maintain that big lead in the race for Driver of the Year? For Neil Bonnett, the question, how will he do in his return after being out of commission for 3 years? And for Robbie Gordon, how will he do driving in the shadow of Davey Allison? Questions. A lot to be asked today at Talladega. Answers are set to unfold in this hot, scorching, record-setting heat.
Joined by my colleague, Ned Jarrett. Ned, this is always an event of high intensity, but I can't ever recall in all those races since 1969 a time where there's been such an emotional level and a record crowd here today. And of course, the heat of factor, where they've had a record-breaking heat every day as we settle down for this 500-mile event.
Well, the heat certainly will be a factor today in this race, Ken. And yes, the emotions have been very high. They're always high when we come to the Talladega Super Speedway because of the intense competition and the high speeds they run here. But then everyone's mind has been on Davey Allison and their family this week. And certainly our prayers continue to go out to Liz, the children, Bobby, Judy, and the entire Allison family. But life goes on, and if life goes on, the race goes on, and no one would want us to race any more than Davey Allison. That's the way he would want everyone here doing their absolute best. So this race will go on today, and yes, there are a lot of things in this race that are going to make it very interesting. How about the emotions and the pressure on 24-year-old Robbie Gordon, who was named to drive the Robert Yates car number 28, which Davey Allison has driven so successfully over the years. Now, Robbie Gordon comes to us with some very impressive credentials. He has won in just about every form of competition he has raced in since he was a kid, but he has very little experience in stock cars. Can he handle the draft? Yesterday afternoon in practice, they were giving him some pretty good lessons out there. They were passing him high and passing him low and giving him something to think about overnight. He's a very talented young man. It'll be interesting to see how he does handle it. And then our colleague Neil Bonnett, choosing the hottest day we've had in years at a stock car race to come and make his comeback. And he wants to have some fun out here today, but one thing that he does not want to do, and that is to interfere with anyone else out there or harm anyone that might be running for points. And we just hope that his concern for his fellow drivers won't take away too much from his natural aggressive style. But I think Neil's going to do okay.
We're just about ready for the command to fire them up and get underway here. So let's go down now for the command. Gene Stallings, the head coach of the Crimson Tide from the University of Alabama, the national football champions, about to make the key call of the day.
And now to introduce to you this afternoon the grand marshal for today's race, the coach for the Alabama Crimson Tide, Mr. Gene Stallings.
Drivers, start your engines.
How's that sound with the motor running, Bobby?
Jimmy Limbaugh, I know CBS is listening to you.
Let's go down to Mike Joy right now and get more on the heat story here at Talladega as we prepare for the Die Hard 500. Mike?
Well, Ken, these cars are designed to cheat the wind, not get air to the driver. This motor pumps out intense heat. The windshield, the sun bakes in just like it does when you park your car at the mall all day. The side window on the right side is closed. That flat back window takes in a lot of sunlight and with it a lot of heat. Before Ernie Irvin fired his engine, it was 114 degrees inside this car. But the drivers have ways to cope with this heat. David Hobb shows us how.
Mike, as you say, these cars are just one 3,500-pound heat sink, and a lot of that heat comes off the engine through the floor and the driver's feet to help combat it. We've got fiberglass Kevlar matting, a bit of space-age material here. That cuts down that heat a lot. They take in air off the skin of the car in this knacker duct, comes down this insulated tube to the air pump. The pipe size drops, increases the velocity, and it goes through this heat exchanger. This ice box is full of ice, and of course the air, when it comes out the other side, is really nice and cool. And it goes round this pipe into the driver's helmet and puts super cold air around the driver's head. Some of them have a V in this pipe to help cool the back of the seat as well. This is another insulated pipe to extract hot air out of the car. And of course, these drivers are going to lose somewhere in the region of 2 liters of water or fluid an hour. And this box here is going to fill them up with them, as apart from their fuel stops as well. So it's going to be a real hot day, and in spite of all this equipment, those drivers are going to get just awfully, awfully hot this afternoon.
And David, these black cars are about 10 degrees hotter than the other ones. Black absorbs heat. Kyle Petty says he may lose as much as 12 pounds today. He wears a size 34 waist in his pants. He brings a pair of drawstring pants with him to Talladega and says he'll cinch him up about 2 inches tighter to cover what he'll lose in water weight today. The 42 cars that'll start the Die Hard 500 are rolling past for the first of the pace laps. Go upstairs to Ken Squire with the starting grid for today's race.
Row one features Bill Elliott on the pole for the first time in 93 and the Die Hard champ from a year ago, Ernie Irvin. Row two, it's Brett Bodine and Kyle Petty. In row three, Ricky Rudd, winner at Michigan on CBS, and Rick Mass. Row four is Greg Sachs and the rookie sensation, Jeff Gordon. Row five, it's Hutch Strickland and Rick Wilson. In row six, the four-time winner of the Die Hard 500, Dale Earnhardt and Harry Gantt. Row seven is Michael Waltrip and Robbie Gordon. Row eight, Dale Jarrett, and the two-time winner here, Darrell Waltrip. In row nine, it's Jimmy Means and Boy Allen Jr. Row 10 is Jimmy Hensley and Neil Bonnet. Row 11, Ted Musgrave and Sterling Marlin. For row 12, Morgan Shepherd and Jimmy Horton. Row 13, Mark Martin and Wally Gollenbach Jr. Row 14 is Jimmy Spencer and Ken Schrader. Row 15, the 86th champion of this event, Bobby Hillen and Jeff Purvis. Row 16 is Derek Cope and Rusty Wallace. In row 17, Jeff Bodine is there with Kenny Wallace. Row 18, Alabama's Stanley Smith and the 89 winner, Terry Labonte. Row 19, Bill Parsons and Dick Trickle. Richard Petty's nephew, Richie Petty, is on the inside of row 20, and there's Lake Speed. The provisional starters in row 21 are Bobby Labonte and the 76 Die Hard 500 champion, Dave Marcus.